Republican leader John Boehner held his own jobs conference, and I spoke to Mr. Boehner a short time ago about bringing an end to the Democrats' job-killing policies, including health care. Take a listen. You had a key vote on the House that's going to extend the estate tax, the death tax, the inheritance tax, as far as I can tell, and keep it at a 45% tax rate. Shouldn't we abolish the estate tax? I mean, isn't that a big tax on capital that we need to create jobs?
The estate tax is due to go away entirely next year. And I and Republicans on both sides of the Capitol want it to go away forever. But we've got our Democrat colleagues who want to keep this tax around. And so they offered this bill today that Republicans voted against that would provide an exemption that basically would be current law. A $3.5 million per person exemption, but a 45% tax rate on everything above that. I think it ought to go to zero. That's what Republicans offered. We did not win this issue today, but I think this issue will be around the Senate for a little while, later this year and next year, and we're likely to get something that everyone can live with.
I mean, I never understood why death should be a taxable event. You've heard that before. But when you look at all this stuff out there, you got big increases in the personal tax rate that could take it up to 45% from 35%. And if this crazy Afghan tax rate kicks in, then it's going to go to 50%. You're going to run down the Bush tax cuts, which means more capital gains taxes, more dividends taxes. You got the state tax thing. It seems to me there's a misunderstanding. Don't you need capital? All this is capital. The top rate is capital. Capital gains is capital. How can you create jobs? How can you help businesses to expand without capital formation and investment, which is being taxed? This is what I don't get.
Larry, listen. This is really pretty simple. We can't grow an economy and grow the government at the same time. And what's going on here, and what's been going on all year, is the government's getting bigger. And as government gets bigger, it takes more from the private sector. That's less that's allowed to be in the hands of businesses and others to reinvest in our economy, and it's less for the American people to reinvest in their own families. And at the end of the day, what we have to do is we've got to shrink the size of government in Washington, allow businesses and American families to keep more of what they earn. We'll have our economy going very well if we're willing to do that.
Now, you had your own sort of job summit where you met with some distinguished economists. What came out of that? What did you get today?
Well, the number one issue that came out of my little mini job summit was tell the president and Speaker Pelosi to stop the job-killing agenda. You know, I used to be a small businessman. You know, I went into debt. I started a business. I hired people. I know how this works. But I'm working with people who've never had a job in the real world. President Obama, Speaker Pelosi, Majority Leader Reid, they've never had a real job. And as a result, they've got all this faith in government. But the economists told us this. As long as the government is talking about tax rates that are going to increase, they're talking about the government takeover of health care, they're talking about this national energy tax, their cap and trade proposal, all this is hanging out there, providing all this uncertainty from Washington. And so employers are doing nothing but putting the money in the bank and waiting for some certainty to work before they're willing to invest in our economy.
Well, there's a report going around today from President Obama's meeting. The AFL-CIO has come into this meeting, apparently, with a $400 to $500 billion of additional spending, mostly, sir, to hire more federal workers as an answer to the 10.2% unemployment rate. What's your thought on this? $400 to $500 billion to hire federal workers? Is that a job plan?
Listen, we already spent $1 trillion in their stimulus bill that, remember, unemployment wasn't going to exceed 8%, but now it's at 10.2. We were going to create jobs immediately, but 3 million people have lost their jobs since this bill has become law. And so you've got a $400 or $500 billion proposal coming out of the AFL-CIO. The Speaker Pelosi comes out today for a $300 billion stimulus bill. All they want to do is grow the size of government.
What's in her
government
bill?
Government doesn't create jobs.
What's in her? I'm sorry, I missed Ms. Pelosi's bill. What's the key point there? Is it like the AFL bill?
It's just like the stimulus bill. They want to call it a jobs bill because stimulus bill, you know, has been tainted because it isn't working. Because all it is about growing the size of government. We've got to lower tax rates and allow American families and small businesses to keep more of what they earn. It's the only way to get our economy going again.
But there's virtually no one in President Obama's cabinet with any business experience. Have you ever looked at that? There's virtually no one in that cabinet with any real private sector business experience.
That's right. Listen, I've talked to them. You know, it's like talking to a wall because they don't understand the dynamics of our free enterprise system.
Mm. Thank you very much for visiting with us, sir. All right, you can see the full interview with House Republican Leader John Boehner on CNBC.com. Coming up on the...